Assalamualaikum, my dear students, viewers and spectators. Welcome to Professor Ghulam Hussain Bhatti Chemistry Channel. The topic of today's discussion is yield, theoretical yield, actual yield, and percentage yield. Very important article of chapter number 1, first year chemistry. Now, students, first of all, what is yield? The amount of product obtained in a chemical reaction is called yield. Now, there are two types of yield, theoretical yield and actual yield. First of all, I will explain theoretical yield. Theoretical yield is also called calculated yield or expected yield. Now, the amount of product calculated from the balanced chemical equation. When we calculate the amount of product from the balanced chemical equation, then that kind of yield is called theoretical yield. And in this type of yield, maximum amount of product can be obtained. And that is why theoretical yield is always greater than, actual yield. Because we can calculate the yield here theoretically. Now, there is a short question. Why theoretical yield is greater than actual yield? What is the reason behind? My dear students, what is the reason behind? Now, there are four reasons. Number one, mechanical loss of the product during filtration. Filtration and separation by distillation, drying, washing, and crystallization. And in this way, there is mechanical loss of the product in case of actual yield. Because when we do actually, then falling losses will be obtained with the help of following techniques: filtration, distillation, drying, washing, and crystallization. Now, the second reason is sometime reactions will be reversible. Reaction will be reversed and we cannot calculate the actual product, actual yield. Now, reason number three, side reaction takes place. Due to the side product when produced during a chemical reaction, that side product will reduce the amount of product which is required. Now, and last one is carelessness or negligence behavior of a chemist during the calculations, during obtaining a product from a chemical reaction. These are the four reasons behind why theoretical yield is always greater than actual yield. It is an important short question as per board paper point of view. Dear students, now what is called actual yield? Actual yield is also called experimental yield. The amount of product that is actually obtained in a chemical reaction is called actual yield. जो हम actually amount of product हासिल करते हैं chemical reaction के दौरान theoretically नहीं हासिल करते बल्कि practically करते हैं उसको actual yield कहते हैं. It has few properties. Now, what are the properties of actual yield? Number one, it is obtained by weighing the purified and dried product obtained as a result of chemical reaction. That is, हम इसको weight करते हैं, purify करते हैं और फिर इसको dry करते हैं, then we can get the amount of product. And second point is, actual yield is always less than theoretical yield. क्यों कम होता है? We will discuss over here. Now, dear students, what is called percentage yield? Percentage yield is also called efficiency of a reaction. Dear students, the yield which is obtained by dividing actual yield with theoretical yield and actual yield divided by theoretical yield and multiply by it with 100 is called percentage yield. The yield which is obtained by dividing actual yield with theoretical yield and multiply by it with 100 is called percentage yield. Now, dear students, there is a short question. How we can calculate efficiency of our action? Or what is the significance of percentage yield? Dear students, now, percentage yield indicates the efficiency of a reaction. यानी इससे हम reaction की efficiency को जो है वो देख सकते हैं. More the percentage yield, higher will be the efficiency of a reaction. यानी अगर percentage yield ज़्यादा होगी तो इसका मतलब है reaction की efficiency बहुत अच्छी है, बहुत precise reaction किया गया है. More the percentage yield, higher will be the efficiency of the reaction. And dear students, last one is the efficiency of a reaction can be determined with the help of percentage yield. This is the answer of this short question. How we can calculate the efficiency of a reaction? And efficiency of a reaction can be calculated with the help of percentage yield. Thank you very much for watching my video. I have explained yield, theoretical yield, actual yield, and percentage yield with the help of all the possible short questions. Dear students, please like, subscribe, and share my video with your friends. Thank you.